sweater at Frida's. You know what we haven't done in a long time on this show? Some Three Chefs action. Please welcome our three chefs today. We got Marilyn Smith, Massimo Cockrock, Randy Feltus, all in our Christmas splendor. My goodness, you, such a subtle sweater you chose, Marilyn.
You know, I think you should, you know, advertise. Anyway, guys.
Absolutely. It's a good look.
You know what? We thought we'd get all decked out in Christmas regalia because we want to do some Christmas-inspired cooking, right? Mm-hmm. So we know that you're very good as a home economist with using leftovers. You're going to use some leftovers for a couple of our meals.
Yep.
And Massimo, you're going to start us off with a stuffed chicken.
A stuffed chicken. Beautiful.
What are you
gonna
stuff
my favorite
it with?
Stuff. Absolutely. I'm going to stuff, well, I'm going to do a basic standard stuffing that can be actually expanded into many different fillings. So this is a general stuffing made with breadcrumb, cheese, vegetables, and parsley. And then you can add, for Christmas, you can add cranberries, you can add all the dry fruit, you can add chestnuts, you can add squash. Mm-hmm. What else would you add in it?
Whatever you
Cipollina,
like.
Whatever. You know, put
bacon's always
put
good.
Sparkles in it.
Booze.
Sure. Booze.
Booze.
Yeah, booze is always there anyway.
Sausage.
Oh my, Madeline,
you're
already in the Christmas spirit. I love it. So what we do is, if I may start over here,
yeah,
we have a
it.
Deboned chicken.
Okay.
And this is perfectly deboned, half chicken. You can have your butcher do it. I mean, he's going to swear at you, but I mean...
it's Merry Christmas.
Merry Christmas. So we have breadcrumb, Italian breadcrumb I prefer, or the white part of Wonder Bread, you know, like regular white bread. Just put through the food processor, that would be
amazing. She's never bought that in her life. She's like, regular
Are you
white
speaking
bread?
English?
Yes.
Wonder Bread? No.
Why not?
That's what it's good for.
Really? Is that really good? Okay,
so
good.
I've sauteed my vegetables, a little bit of butter and oil. And I sauteed them just to bring out the sweetness of it.
Mm.
Otherwise, if you put raw vegetables in, I find that they taste too acid and too raw. Well, because they are raw. So I'm going to put a nice amount in it because I want a lot of vegetables in my filling.
Could you just eat that?
Yes,
okay.
You can just
well,
eat that.
Okay.
Put
it,
spread
I'm
it on
gonna
the
try.
Bread. Yeah,
mix it.
We're going to bind it with a little bit of...
Is it turnip or rutabaga and carrot?
No, just celery, onion, and carrot, and garlic.
A little mirepoix.
A little mirepoix. Put a little bit of that.
Oh, this looks good already.
Parsley, yeah, absolutely.
And you cut it off really nice
and
small, right?
Let's not forget Parmigiano Reggiano.
Hey, swear by it, live by it.
Parmigiano Reggiano, that's the only grated cheese that can be used.
I have Asiago.
Or Grana Padano, that's,
is Asiago
I should say
bad?
That.
I like the rules, I don't mind the rules at all.
Go ahead.
Okay, Marilyn, you can use your cheese too,
and
honey.
Yeah, because I've
There's
got
nothing
Asiago.
Wrong with your Asiago.
Okay, what are you making?
I'm gonna make the leftovers. I'm gonna make peasant
right,
dinner.
Let's do this.
Okay, good.
I have a little piece of parchment paper. I'm gonna make it easy for everybody, yeah? We take our chicken. Now, we flattened it, we left the skin on because the skin is good for you.
It's tasty.
Not a problem. Mix.
Sorry.
Maybe a little bit of salt.
I'm using my hands.
Yeah.
I'm going to get in there. I'm going to get aggressive.
Yeah, boom. A little bit of pepper.
Yep.
Go ahead. Make it nice and pasty and put a nice line in the middle over here. Not too much,
He's
but I mean,
you
roll
around,
it out.
Randy?
I like it.
Yeah, I like it too.
Little much?
No, that's
You're
going to
make that one happen,
no,
aren't
that's
you?
That's perfect. And then we just roll it up. Just like that.
It's like a big sushi.
Yeah, exactly.
Right.
A sushi roll.
The French might call it a Ballantine.
A Ballantine?
Let's not bring that up.
I'm sorry.
Okay, put that on the side. We got our bacon because I don't want to tie it. I don't like
Who
things that are tied.
Who knew there was bacon involved in this recipe? I like how you just did that.
You know what?
It wasn't on the inside. It's going on the outside.
It's going on the outside. That's right. We got to put bacon somehow. So we have beautiful bacon over
here. That's beautiful
And what bacon. We do is we just stretch it out. Nice and thin.
Yeah.
Okay.
Right.
Buy good quality bacon. Okay. Always buy good quality bacon.
Did you get that at a butcher, right?
Yes.
Yeah.
The better quality bacon you buy, the better it is. Now make this nice and tight. Okay. Just roll it out like
and
that,
wrap
and
it
then
up.
We wrap it up with the bacon. Okay.
Ooh.
Yes.
You like the way that's looking, don't you?
Let's move out
Very
some
good
of
idea.
This stuff here. There you go. Let's move out that, and just like so.
Nice. Okay,
and
so what are you actually
Well,
bake
this
that.
One,
how long is that going to take?
We're going to bake this one here at 375.
Uh-huh.
I'll show you a trick that I have also.
Are those
because
yours?
It's like
mine.
This, it falls apart, right?
Do you want me to turn it down?
We take our parchment paper.
Okay, good.
We roll it again.
Sorry, we had a small disaster over here.
What happened?
Never mind, don't look.
Don't look.
Everything's fine. Everything's good.
Look away.
We were responsible just for one pan, and it didn't work out.
And we were mesmerized by what you're doing.
Okay, what I'm doing is this, okay? I'm putting it in the parchment paper.
Yes.
Just like that. Because I want my bacon to crisp, all right?
Yeah.
Now, I have a little roasting pan over here.
Okay.
All right? I put it in the parchment paper. Now, with the heat, is going to go through the parchment paper, is going to roast beautifully without unraveling and falling apart.
Yeah, and okay? Grease all over your kitchen
exactly.
Or your oven too.
Yeah, now
true.
This one goes 375 in the oven, boom, like that.
Boom.
About 45 minutes.
45?
Oh, you know, 30 minutes, 45 minutes.
The bacon's got to get in there.
Yeah.
It's got to crisp up and in.
Right.
Okay. And what you take out of the oven is this.
Is this.
Which I'm going to give you. This
okay,
is cold
right
now.
You're going to give me some, right?
You require a cold. Look. This is cooked in here
and
just unwrapped.
Oh, that looks good and not greasy at all.
Well,
Gina, I'm really glad that you used canola oil on this.
It's fine, it's fine.
It's fine.
I'm not mad at you.
But nice
fine.
To point it out. you know,
so it looks like this, right? Okay, what?
Take a look at that, right?
Meryl's like, what? My turn now.
Is it my turn? Is it my turn?
Go ahead. Do you want me to slice some for you?
I do, but chunk it up. Chunk it up.
What do you mean, chunk it up?
Chunk it up.
Like,
no.
Like that?
I want little pieces that are like.
Like that?
Yeah, maybe into quarters, okay?
Well,
okay, so this
I mean.
Is called peasant dinner, and I used to make it all the time.
She's
peasant,
too.
I'm ready to
see your side
of everyone.
Yeah, I'm always sweet with you.
Before we get, yeah, you are.
I am.
I like that
good.
Side of you.
Not yet!
Oh, man!
I'm leaving.
Sorry, Chef. So, the bacon wrapped chicken is going to be on our website, so
right.
cityline.ca. So now we are moving on.
Yes, because
Bossy Boots has a recipe here.
Because if you just warm that up, I don't think that would be as wonderful. So I think you should make creativity with leftovers.
Absolutely. Like,
okay, so
be
this
creative.
Is called, be creative. So I've got some healthy canola oil in here with some onion and garlic. Yeah. And then I put some leftover roasted potatoes because I have like a lot of those in my house all the time.
Leftover
roasted potatoes. And then put your chicken in now.
You gotta cook less.
Huh? I gotta what?
You gotta cook less. You got too much left over.
Well, no. I have a 23-year-old son. Oh, my God.
Oh, my God. You gotta keep him busy.
Oh, honestly. Okay, so you would heat this all up until it was nice and warmed through.
Yes.
And then while that's happening, I'm gonna put some sage in. Look, I did chefy things.
Beautiful.
Yeah,
that's chef.
That's
chef. And then I've got about 6 omega-3 eggs and a little bit of water. This is kind of like a fake frittata, a fake whatever.
Yep.
It's a lot of fake stuff. And so, because, you know, some people are better at faking things than others. Anyway.
You passed out.
Anyway, whatever. Anyway, and then some. Why isn't that working? Who cares? Anyway, so then I would cook this more. Oh, I want pepper. Thank you. I would cook this a bit more, and then you know, like do it like an omelet-y thing.
Yeah.
Yeah. Isn't that annoying? Anyway, here. Let's just shove them up.
They're
my...
really attached. I thought you could pin them, take them off.
No, there they go. I was going to cut them off,
sleeve.
But I just shoved them up my sleeve. So then you make sure that the egg is going to go underneath, so that it's not going to be raw. You cook it like that.
Yeah.
And then, excuse me, chef.
Yeah.
What did I find down here? A lid, okay. And so you could either cook it like that on top of your stove if you don't have like a pan that you could put in the oven.
Yeah.
Or you could make it like a frittata and bake that in your oven like that.
Mm-hmm.
And then when you go to serve it, you just do your, I'm using
Asiago.
And we're
like
gonna put
part.
Some Asiago
okay
on top.
That's good.
Yeah. That is the real Asiago. I like
yeah, it's really Asiago. And then you just serve it like that and it's like such comfort food and it doesn't look anything like it started off like that.
Yeah.
It actually looks kind of awful, but it tastes really good.
That actually looks good to me.
I can't tell you
how many times we rely on a frittata in my house because you can throw in whatever leftovers you have.
You can totally.
You get good protein in there. The kids will eat it. It's
That's
a smart
right.
idea. Yeah, it's a smart day two meal.
And did you know that Canadians throw out 40% of their food?
We're terrible.
We're terrible.
We're
and
terrible
so as a professional home economist, I don't want you to do that. And people go, ooh, leftovers. And I'm going,
I love leftovers.
Creativity.
They're
so
great.
There you go. So,
okay, really good recipe. We're also putting that on
you.
Our website. And
right.
I kind of feel like you're trying to show me up with your sweaters.
Yeah. What are you talking about?
Oh no!
Oh boy!
I will not be out.
Booyah!
I'm in the Christmas spirit too, people. That's right.
It looks good on you.
We're going to break now. Stay tuned.